So we got Bank of America warning us of a crash and little bit of layoffs. And I say whatever, our economy looks amazing. If you're into parking lots and just sitting there going like, is anyone going to fix this? And Larry Summers says that we have, there is no soft landing. This is stagflation. So if you like bad plus worse, well, you got it. And cue the fire. Amazon is issuing huge warnings, which I am going to show you in this video since you come here for huge. And cue the fire for a third time. We have a TLT trade. I need you guys to pay attention to this. I know everyone's like, Bitcoin, 100X. If you want to double your money, okay, you got to look at other things out there. There is things, I'm just saying. Other than gold and silver, yeah, Microsoft, or maybe a little McDonald's. So we will dive into that. And France doesn't like the macaroni guy. France gets a downgrade. Huh, that's weird. And breaking news coming in from what I look like when I'm trading every day is like, oh, what is happening here? Like the whole everything could be completely on fire. And it's like, oh, bravo, the stock market went up today. All right, I hear you. We have a notorious recession indicator says that an economic downturn. Huh, when's it gonna begin? Oh, okay, right now. Bank of America is telling you. I know that you just click the like button to help save this channel, but we have a recession that is about 5 feet, 7 feet in front of us. And for some reason, everyone thinks it's a great idea to front run the Fed, and we're fine. Everything's fine. Guys, there is a high probability that you're going to lose a shat ton of money. And I know everything's fine. Well, besides it all being gone. And I feel like these guys, right? And I've told you just, okay, because I'm going with you on Monday. All right, I'll close my position on SPX, SPY. We'll see how that one lands. We'll see if I'm 5 for 5 or if I can carry it for one more day. But at least, kids, pack a parachute. I mean, breaking news. Look at these guys. This is so difficult. Don't you love trading? I love trading. It's tough because it weeds out. Yo, you just couldn't do it, could you? It's okay. You go home. You leave this for the big traders. Bank of America, top global strategist warns there is plenty of room for more S&P 5 downside. As 80% of recessions since, I thought it was 100%, 1933 have torpedoed stocks by 20% after they've started. But have we started? No. But are we hella close? I'm gonna say yes. Just to show you in the charts. Okay, the green area is a recession. This is 2000, okay? The market goes down. But wait, it gets better. There's actually more of them. Oh, hold on. Here's another one. 2008. That was delicious. Market went from double top all the way down to losing 54%. So if you're okay with that, if you are okay, I am okay. And then we pivot on over to this last one. This was just a shot in the pan. Did I say that right? Is it a shot in the pan or You have nothing to pee in. 21% in the pan. All right, so now the probabilities. The Fed is telling you, we're going into a recession. But the market's like, no, we're fine. No, there's a problem with central banks. They have never, in the history of central banks, they're not even allowed to say the word recession. They're like, yep, it looks like we're heading into one. So you better buckle up, buttercup. And everyone's like, let's go all in. Which I say on the monthly, on your MACD, you actually have a reversal. And on the MACD, you had a little fakey. You faked me out. But you can only fake me out once. All right. Then on the S&P 500, this is your major indice, which I am four for five. All right. We're gonna see tomorrow what plays out. I don't want it to go up here. Also, this looks like a rising wedge, but it could also be a channel, which is bullish. So any way you look at it, where I'm shorting it. Oh, my finger. I couldn't get into the honeypot. Right there. All right. That's where I shorted it, which we were good. I was good. I could have taken profit. I'm like, I got this. I just don't want it to go up, come up here and touch this and then head down and touch this. I mean, I'll make a percentage, but I think it's better if tomorrow I exit. I know I can handle it. I'm only down $6, so I can take this for the team. Also, just to let you know, that indicator that I was testing, that YouTube went crazy and everyone's like, it's 100%. You are gonna make so much money. I actually compared it to my swing trading course, along with the bear market course. I had someone code it and I'm like, man, this thing is dialed in. It actually beats it. So everything. And a lot of times you guys don't see this. It goes in colors and it's like, we're actually green. I don't know if you could see red or green, and it's telling you to buy. Also, if you would like this in swing trading, because we are above that white line, that's bull market. Also, white line, the 200-day moving average is moving up. That is also bull market. I also need you to understand that sometimes when we're so bearish for so long, it's hard to get our brain going, wait, we're bullish now? Which in 2020, right? It was bad. It was really bad. And then all of a sudden we got over the 200. I'm like, oh, okay, we're bull market. They're like, are you on drugs? I'm like, no, I'm telling you, look at the fracking charts. It's giving you a buy indicator. No, you don't understand. We're going into a recession. Well, maybe there's some money to be made. So if there is a train coming at you at 300 miles an hour, either A, step off the tracks, or in your dream, be Superman, put the cape on and zoom up. But right now, the green bar, this is green. This is telling you, okay, so the red one, I'll walk you through this. The blue one is the stock market. That is the price. The red one is my Bravo 9. I turned that on. Also 70%, wait, 60. Dang it. Now I got to do it. I don't want to edit this. Okay. I'll give you the better deal. I'll give you 70%. That's so inexpensive for this swing trading course. All of my courses, I'm terrible with numbers. It's like a Big Mac. Do you want a quarter pounder or a one third? Well, I think one third is bigger, right? Your brain just doesn't work. So whatever, the cheapest one I've ever sold the course for, link in the description, grab it. And no, this was not, I did not like, oh, this is a really good marketing strategy. No, this is just me stupid and being lazy. So please take advantage of, and you can turn all this on so you can learn how to trade rather than having Jim Cramer come on and going, what are we doing today, Jimmy? We're gonna buy, we're gonna sell. Guys, the blue arrow is the stock market. The red arrow is my Bravo 9. I like to use that as a swing trade, okay? And then we put in a buy, right. Then when come under, we sell. Also comes with, yes, how to, when to buy, when to sell, but I don't want you doing that. I want you turning that buy, sell off. And it actually looks like crazy woke spaghetti right here. But anyways, the white line is the 200. It's moving up. See this angle? See, that angle is going in that direction. That's a bull market. Not only that, I know we have stagflation and everything's bad and we're going into a recession. Yes, we are. But at the end of the day, you have to sit down and just do what the charts tell you to do. So we're actually going up. And I'm hoping that Monday the market sells off. Maybe even Tuesday, and I could be 5 for 5. But this is telling me, I don't know if you could see that shaded area, you can make it darker. Like we're in a green area, and you could ride these things for such a long time. I have just learned over the course of my life not to be in denial. That's just what happens. You're like, nope, nope, we're going down, and it keeps going up. Nope, 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 fundamentals say down. I mean, even the market insider and Larry Summers and everyone, the U.S. economy is about to hit a slowdown. Well, wouldn't that be the stock market goes down? I know, right? As Americans. No, guys, the stock market is a beauty pageant. You pick and choose. The broader market is terrible. But if you're in a FANG or if you're in this or that, you kind of have to cherry pick the cute ones that go up on stage. As Americans blow through savings, right? You're like, it's horrible. I know. Shrink investments, battle higher interest rates, which, as Larry says, is probably not going to come down. We're in stagflation. The chief says this is all a dumpster fire. And I say, market go up. Trade the charts that are in front of you. Here, I'll let you listen to Larry, and hopefully Bloomberg won't go. We're going to claim this video and take
all of your
money. It's
a little bit upwards, and 4.8% labor cost inflation just does not go with 2% underlying inflation. So I think we've got a bit of a stagflationary problem.
I think we have a little bit. No, we have a big bit. Thank you, Larry, of stagflation. And the Fed, which you're very familiar with that, is completely trapped. I know you guys are like, no, the Fed has this. Okay, can I just ask you this on a 30-year that they're in control of the bond market? Why was it at 4.5 and now it's at 3.5? Doesn't look like too much control to me. Or how the Fed is giving everyone all the way up there 4.8%. This is it right here. Yeah, you want 4.8? All the banks. You guys want 5%? Come on. Not only that, we will give you collateral. And yet everyone is like, you know what? We'd rather do a 3-month and not. Not only that, take a haircut on a 1-month. On a 1-month. Four. And then it actually dropped down to 3.3%. The banks would rather take 3% than almost 5% from the Fed. Hey, Jerome is supposed to be in charge of the short end, and they are not. Not just that, do not expect the Fed to save you. They're not. They couldn't in 2020. I always get this wrong, because I'm old. So 2020 is like 20, like, I don't know. The dates in the brain get a little confusing. But the Fed's not going to save you. Jerome's not going to save you. When it happened in 2020 and they dropped rates to zero, the market went down. I'm just saying. To me, it was yesterday. To you, it could have felt like 20 years ago. The U.S. will suffer a recession. It's going to. It's like 120%. And don't expect the Fed to rescue stocks. Huh? The beauty pageant, when that happens, top economists say. And you want to know who else isn't going to rescue you? The cops. Oh my God. These are actually IRS agents. Come on. You're supposed to be carrying pocket protectors, not freaking. Oh, this is crazy. The IRS is hiring special agents. Prepare to use deadly force. You know what? I'm not paying my. Nope. Like, really? Is there something constitutional about this? Deadly force. And they're being paid $100,000 to shoot people that don't want to pay their taxes. And I say just jail them, right? You don't have to shoot them. I mean, both sides is unconstitutional. You're like, but I don't want my money to go to Ukraine. You're like, oh, too bad. Sorry. Your time is done. Yes, I feel you. Can we not just all go get on an island? We're going to have, look, here, money, gold, silver, Bitcoin. Bitcoin is allowed, even seashells. And then whatever you make, you get to keep. I know, crazy, right? I mean, what are we currently at? 38 plus state? We're in the 50%. Everything that you make, it all, come on. You can't be okay with this. I mean, at least you could just sit, subscribe. Thank you, all the work that I put in. I appreciate you coming on and... Let's see the chat show. We can all just sit back together and then I'll do my videos every day and go, this is how it's all burning down, ladies and gentlemen. Boys and girls, let's gather around, pop our popcorn, forget the soft landing, says research affiliates, equities chief. This is not going to be soft. This is not going to be hard. This is going to be a complete dumpster fire based on the yield curve, which looks something like that over there. Look at this thing. And this thing's going up this week, right? the Fed's going to raise the short end up. Oh my gosh. Just to let you know, this all goes down every single time. It looks like this. It'll look like that. That end will come down there. This end will come the other way. But what will go up? Well, I am glad you asked. That would be the bond market and yields. And if you want to take advantage of it, I mean, I'm sure you're looking at this chart. You're like, oh, that doesn't. It's not so much. This is 50%. These are 50% swings. And everyone's just waiting for Bitcoin. And they're like, well, once this pops, it's going to double. It does it in... Look at my Bravo's daily watch list. If you took advantage on February 17th and I said, hey, look, that SIVB bank shorted right there from 301 all the way to zero... Your account just exploded. But that's on my bear market. An under the 200 goes down. You make money going down. Also take advantage before that price goes up this week. But now over to the bond market. Look at this. This was almost a 60% from bottom to top. It just does this in everything. You can do gold, you can do silver, you can do Bitcoin, you can do stocks, Microsoft, anything. Well, especially something that is probably going to last for a very long time, even though I don't want it to. I hate bonds, but I am going to make these digits. This was my call. I said this is going to be your low, and we're going to bounce, and then the Fed's going to pivot and double your money. And also, for full transparency, I actually put in a short, and that would be down, well, from that spot. It was so stupid. Sorry, I just have to laugh at myself because it was the clearest head and shoulders I have ever seen in my life. And I was thinking, I'll tell you what's in my head because you're like, tell us, crazy kid, what happened? I was thinking, okay, it's going to sell off and then it's going to come up because I had to do it 1 year out. So you could have lost money or it wouldn't have been the right timing. So I'm like, okay, by then it'll be up. It's currently not. So I'm still down a few percent. That's what I did on the channel. But in my retirement account, yes, I have been accumulating in these zones. But on the show, I'm probably down right when it broke that head and shoulders. I'm from down there, right there. So it's probably about 15%. I mean, I'm not going to starve to death. I just thought by now the Fed would have broke things. If not, I mean, they're breaking. The timing a little off. Now let's roll the tape and let me just bring you back the S&P 500 because you're very familiar with the S&P 500. Okay, I want to show you this and you can go back, rewind the tape. When you're above the S&P 500, the 200, that one, that's actually going up. That's why I don't want you in denial. So if you have my bear market watch list, move into my bull market watch list. I have many stocks in there. I have many stocks on both sides. So you can trade one and then go over to the other and trade the other. Our percentage from the 200, and you can go back and you can rewind it. Once you get about, I think it's 2.5%, maybe 3%. We're above 5% above the 200. It's not coming back down, but that's a lie. It will, but it's going to take some time. So please come join me with the ride up and then it'll be the ride down. You'll be like, but you're flip-flopping. 1 minute you're bull, the next minute you're bear. Yes, that is how the stock market works. It goes up, it goes down. Just don't do what everyone else is doing, which has been so painful. When I saw all of the hedge funds shorting this thing, I'm like, oh gosh, they're going to break my ladder. I would prefer to be contrarian. Just do whatever they're doing. Hedge funds just completely do the opposite. Jimmy over here. Jimmy, just do what are we doing today, Jimmy? Hold on. Okay. So if Jimmy is telling you to buy, you should probably be selling sell. And on this last trade, I'm like, ugh, you got me. But please join the fun. It's like a video game. It's cool. Make digits go higher. But again, it is Sunday. I love you guys. Thanks for subscribing or even hitting the like. Eh. Or taking advantage of my stupidity where I'm like, is it 100%? Is it completely free? Good job, Bravo. And I will see you tomorrow.